Welcome to this video lecture series on antenna and wave propagation. In this video lecture, we'll discuss the reflector antennas. We have already discussed various types of reflector antennas. Now we'll go into the working of reflector antennas. First, we'll see the flat sheet reflector, then we'll see the corner reflector, and at last we'll see the parabolic reflector. Parabolic reflector is really important, so we'll go in detailing of parabolic or paraboloid reflector. So first begin with the flat sheet reflector. So flat sheet reflector, as you have already seen my video on the types of reflector antenna, you must know that the flat sheet reflector looks like a flat sheet. So it acts like a mirror. So if this is my flat sheet reflector and this is my object. Now object in this case is an antenna which is radiating its beam in a particular direction. So now, as I already said, that reflector antennas works on the principle of image theory. So when I take the high frequency waves, the waves start behaving like the rays of light. So the image principles are accurately applicable on reflector antennas as well. So now EM waves are also behaving like the rays of light, and we'll see that all of the antennas and reflecting surfaces are working on the principles of ray of lights. So now this is my object. This is acting like a mirror. As I said, it is in accordance with the ray of light principles. So this flat sheet reflector is acting like a mirror. So when a flat sheet reflector is there, the object produces its image. So the image is placed at the same distance as the object is placed. So if the distance of object from the mirror is S, the distance of image also is S. So the total distance between object and image is, so this is image, so total distance is 2 of S. So now if I remove this flat sheet reflector, so O is denoting my object and I is denoting my image antenna. So now object antenna and image antenna are placed 2S distance apart. Also the image antenna has opposite characteristic with respect to the object antenna, as it is the image of object antenna and the characteristics are reversed. So I can say that the image and O has opposite phases and having 2S distance between them. So I can treat them as array of two antennas having 2S distance between them. So it is array of two antennas having 2S distance between them and having opposite phase. So I have already studied about array of two antennas having some distance and opposite phase. So I can solve this problem. So now coming to this problem, this is the flat sheet reflector and I am considering this to be my object antenna. So now the object antenna would radiate. So it starts radiating. So it radiates here, here, here. So these are called my direct rays. Also, after coming to this flat sheet reflector, my radiations would travel back. So it will reflect. Again, it will reflect. So the maximum limit of reflected wave would be this. So this would be the maximum limit of reflected rays, and this is reflected ray. Also, I can say that the direct wave also go up to this point. So in this portion I am getting either direct waves or direct reflected waves. So this portion is called my region 1. In region 1, I'll get my maximum illumination. If I'm considering this to be a light source, in the region 1, I'll get my maximum illumination. But in this region, in this region, only direct rays are present. In this region, my reflected rays won't be present. So it is partially illuminated. So this region is called my region 2. Also, this is the edge of the flat sheet reflector. So at the edge, I know if a light encounters some edge at the edge it starts bending. So this property is called diffraction of light. Again in EM waves also diffraction occurs. So this is the maximum limit of diffraction. Here this is also the maximum limit of diffraction. This is diffracted waves. This is maximum limit of diffraction. This is called my region 3. Region 3 is not at all illuminated. So I have region 1 which is totally illuminated. Here direct rays plus reflected rays both are present. Second is region 2 which is partially illuminated. Here only direct rays are present, no reflected waves. So region 3. Region 3 is not illuminated. In region 3 only diffracted rays. Diffracted rays are also, as you can know, then the corners are very few and the diffracted rays would be very few. So it is like not at all illuminated. So only diffracted rays are present. So now this was all about the flat sheet reflector. I hope you can understand the flat sheet reflector is acting like a flat mirror and it will produce an array of two antennas which will increase the directivity. So now coming to the corner reflector. Corner reflector, as you know, are the two flat sheets of reflector which are connected at some angle. So I am first taking the angle to be 90 degrees. So if my object antenna is A and object antenna is placed here. So due to this surface, first I am taking 90 degrees, so this angle is 90 degrees. So due to this surface, a image would be produced. So this I am taking to be I1. The I1 would be of opposite nature to the A. So I am taking I1 to be cross and this to be a simple dot. Similarly, I2 is produced due to this surface. So now again if I extend these surface, due to these two surfaces another image would produce which is called I3. Now I3 is the opposite nature of I1 and I2. So I3 is similar nature of A. So now I am getting these three antennas as the images and the combination of all the four in an array will give me the final output radiation pattern. Similarly, I can take the angle to be 45 degrees. So I hope you can understand when the angle is reduced, the images would be increased. So the angle is half of 90 degrees. Here I get four antennas. Here I should get eight antennas. So due to this, this is my antenna A. Now due to this, this image and this image is produced. So now I'll get another images due to these images also. So another images will produce of opposite nature to this. So because of this, this image would produce. Because of this, this image would produce. Similarly, I can get various images. Similarly, I'll get the images in 60 and 30 degree. So now here A is my antenna. These are my images. I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. I6, I7. So I have 7 images and 1 antenna, and the combination of all 8 antennas in this array would give me the final output radiation. Similarly, all the 6 antennas in this array would give me the final output radiations. And similarly, all the 12 antennas in this array would give me the final output radiation. So I hope you can understand how the image theory in corner reflector antennas is working. So now coming to the parabolic reflector. So we'll see the characteristics of parabolic surface, then we'll move to the parabolic antenna and the paraboloid antenna. So we are taking this to be my parabolic surface. So in this parabolic surface, my OO dash is the axis of parabola. Now OF is the focal length. I hope you understand what is a focus. Focus is the point in the front of parabola where the radiations would go to the parabola and becomes parallel. Or else the parallel radiations would come to the parabola and concentrate at the focus. So this point is called my focus. So the characteristic of the parabolic antenna is that King K as a constant. So FP1, this distance plus this distance is equal to this distance plus this distance is equal to this distance plus this distance. So FP1 plus P1 P1 dash, FP1 plus P1 P1 dash is equal to FP2 plus P2 P2 dash is equal to FP3 plus P3 P3 dash. So this is the property of the parabola. If any structure obeys this property, it is called a parabolic structure. So the phenomena of parabolic structure is that it produces high gain. It produces high gain and directional rays. Second, it converts circular polarized waves into planar waves. So I hope you can understand, if I am taking my object antenna to be here and it is producing circular waves, after getting reflected from the parabolic reflector, these circular waves are converted into planar waves. So this is the property of parabolic reflector antenna. Now coming to the paraboloid antenna. So what is paraboloid antenna? When I take the parabolic antenna and rotate it into 360 degree around the axis of antenna, so the axis of antenna is O dash, and if I rotate my parabolic surface around O dash in 360 degree, I'll get a surface which is looking like this, and this structure is called paraboloid. So when the parabolic surface is rotated 360 degree around the axis of parabola, that is OO dash, we get paraboloid surface. So the structure looks like this and the radiation pattern looks like this. It has a major lobe and these are minor lobes. This is axis. So as you can see, I am getting highly directed wave. So these are the types of paraboloid. So first is parabolic cylinder. So if I cut the cylinder surface and I get some portion of the cylinder surface, it is called parabolic cylinder. These all surface will qualify these criteria of parabolic antenna. So now another is cut out paraboloid. So if instead of full paraboloid, if I have some small strip, it is called cut out paraboloid. Third is pillbox. Pillbox is the covered portion. So if I cover this also, I'll get the pillbox. So next portion is paraboloid torus. So the paraboloid torus looks like this. So in this structure, this is somewhat slanted. So the next structure is offset paraboloid. If I am exciting this structure, so it is a full paraboloid structure and I am exciting it somewhat downside. So we'll come to the feed methods of parabolic reflector also. There you'll be more clarified about this offset paraboloid reflector. So as of now, you can understand that a paraboloid structure is there. Also some excitation antenna is placed, downsided, and it is tilted. So this type of structure is called offset paraboloid antenna. So now coming to the advantages. So first advantage is that it is highly directional. Second advantage is that when the aperture area is greater than 10 lambda, it gives me high gain. That is, at aperture area greater than 10 lambda, I am getting high gain. Third is, it is used at ultra high frequency and microwave frequency. So now coming to the disadvantage. So the first disadvantage of this structure is that to get high gains, my aperture area should be greater than 10 lambda. So it does not work when it is very small. So the next disadvantage is that it has minor lobes. So a lot of energy is going into minor lobes, and because of this, some false detections would be present. So I'll conclude this session here. I hope you like this video. Like this video, subscribe this channel, and stay tuned for the further videos. Thank you.